Welcome to another installment of Ganpati Om Downtown's online offerings. So join us today. Grab whatever you might need, a blanket, a block, bolster, eye pillow, whatever you might need to be comfortable. And let's begin our practice in child's pose today. Big toes are touching, knees can be as wide as you like. And just to let your upper body drape over your legs and release down. Let the arms come to a comfortable position. They're either out in front of you, alongside you, or if the head is not touching the ground, they're supporting the head, just underneath the forehead. Let the eyes close, let the lips come together. Start to direct the breath through the nose. Feel an expansion in your belly as you breathe in. And then as you breathe out, just notice as the belly draws back towards the spine, the lungs empty. Start to take that breath in a little bit deeper. So not only do you feel the belly expand, the rib cage begins to expand as well. As the exhale comes, the ribs contract, the belly comes back in. You can help it if you'd like, pulling gently in through that kind of navel area, drawing back towards the spine. Continuing with that breathing, the next time you inhale, as you feel the belly and the ribs, take that breath right up towards the collarbones, feel the lungs expand to their absolute fullest. And then as you exhale, empty from the top, slowly working your way down, belly drawing in, every last bit of stale air is gone, and then the breath comes in again. Moving into your complete yogic breathing. And feel yourself relaxing with every exhale. Feel your body just settling, growing heavy. Tension beginning to slip away. Muscular tension, mental tension, even emotional tension. Let it go for now. And just immerse yourself in your breath. So some of you may choose to bring the ujjayi breath into your practice now, constricting the glottis so that you can hear the sound of the inhale and the sound of the exhale. Slowly extend those arms all the way out in front of you, straighten them out, spreading the fingers wide. Look at the space between the thumbs, make sure your feet can fit there, and then pull yourself up onto your hands and your knees, adjusting your knees to a hip distance stance. So that would mean about two of your own fists could fit in between those knees. Ankles are directly behind the knees, tops of the feet are heavy. Start to really grip with your hands now.
helps to just distribute the weight across the entire palm and not put it all into those wrists. So let's inhale now. Lift the chin and the tailbone up. Look up. Exhale, draw the tailbone slowly down as you tuck the chin and round the back. And then inhale again. Lift the chin and the tail. We come into cow pose. Exhale, tuck the chin and the tail and make your way into a cat stretch. A few rounds now. Just move with your breath. Maybe even close your eyes. Another deep breath in. As you exhale, look down between the palms. Inhale, walk your hands back to center. Slide your right leg back to center and then keep sliding it out to the right, stopping when your foot lines up with that left knee. Walk your hands in towards you. Come all the way up to standing on the knee, making sure hip is over knee and ankle on that right leg is lined up with the right hip. Slide the right hand down that right leg. And let's inhale, circle the left arm up to the sky. Turn your palm to the right and lean to the right, looking out to the left if that's available. And just breathe here, in and out through your nose. Keep the shoulders relaxed and down, away from the ears. along the right side of the body. Tuck the tail, pull the belly in. Good, let's inhale the right arm to the ceiling. Exhale, look down to that left hand. Start to lower the right hand down. Walk your hands back around onto your mat. Point your left toes straight back. Slide that right leg straight back. Let's lower the knee. Bring the big toes together. Take it back into child's pose. Just a couple breaths here. Relaxing through the low back. Relaxing the arms, the wrists, the shoulders. Maybe move those hips side to side a few times. And then let your hips come back to center. Reach your arms forward again. Make sure the space can accommodate both the feet there. Pull yourself up to table. Readjust the knees back to hip distance. Let's inhale, lift the chin and the tailbone up. Exhale, tuck the chin, tuck the tail, rounding out the back, and inhale again, back into cow. Make that U shape to the spine. Exhaling up into your cat stretch. Three more breaths. Go as slow as you can, as slow as your breath will let you. Take your last one. When you're done that last one, you're back in a neutral table. Easing straight down. Toes, turn that left big toe just slightly to the right. This helps to keep the hips level. Now inhale, lift the chin, lift the heel, open the throat, point the left toes, squeeze the knee to the chest, forehead draws towards the knee. Inhale and slowly extend the legs. The foot flexes, look up, hips level. Exhale, squeeze it in. Let's do three more. You can even work with your eyes closed.
Last one.
The next inhale, left leg goes back. We just set the top of the foot down. Slide that foot over to the right. Start to walk your hands over to the right. Try to keep shoulders over wrists here as you look over that right shoulder, back for that left foot. Compress the right side and expand the left side. And just keep breathing deeply. Take one more deep breath in, and on your exhale, look down between the hands, walk your hands back to center. Slide your left leg out to the left and forward until your ankle's in line with that right knee. Walk your hands back towards you. Come up to standing on the right knee, the sole of the left foot is planted. Slide the left hand down the side of that left leg. And now let's inhale, circle the right arm up to the ceiling, turning your palm in the direction that left leg is going. Take that side bend over to the left, looking out to the right, and breathing. Roll the right shoulder back. Compress that left side. On your next inhale, come all the way up, turn the palm out, circle the right arm down, release to just the fingerprints for a moment, slide that right hand, knee, and ankle are arched. Let that right palm press to the floor. Let the left arm reach to the sky. Look up towards that thumb. Turn the palm the direction the head is facing and take the arm over the ear. Try to keep angling that pinky finger downwards as you spiral your chest open to the left. bend the right knee. Try to keep the lifted leg, the left leg, straight as possible. Take another deep breath in. As you exhale, start to walk your hands back as you fold down over that right leg, tucking the chin, drawing the forehead in. Can you lift the left leg higher? Another deep breath in, left leg comes up. As you exhale, big step back with the left foot. Take your feet to a hip distance stance, bend deeply into the right knee, look out in front of you. Inhale, sweep the arms forward and all the way up to the ceiling. Pull the shoulders down, away from the ears. Sink those hips nice and low, right hip back, left hip forward. Another inhale, reach up, stretch it back. Let's exhale, lower both arms down. Plant both palms. Let's step back to a downward dog. First one. So take a moment, move around in it if you need to. Make it feel good, stretch things out. Continue to breathe. Pull the shoulders back, away from the ears. Press those heels down. Notice if there's a difference between how the right leg feels compared to the left. Hip, buttock, hamstring. Another deep breath in. Exhale, lower your knees. And step your left foot forward. Walk it close to the left hand. Slide that right leg back as far as you can. Look forward, lift the chin, open the throat, melt the hips down. So if you have issues with your knees at all, don't be afraid to place a towel underneath the knee, a blanket. Keeping it supported, keeping it comfortable. Try not to have any pain through your yoga practice. Finding that place of comfortable discomfort in every pose you come into. Keep sinking the hips down, keep lifting the crown of the head upwards. One more inhale. Exhale, place your left hand on top of your left knee. And when your inhale comes, reach that right arm forward and all the way up. As you look up, straighten that left arm, moving the shoulders back, sending that thumb back. Keep sinking the hips down towards the ground. Try to open the chest, open the throat. Take another inhale, really extend it back. And as you exhale, let the right fingers come down. And then the left fingers come down. Curl the right toes under. hands on the floor, you can bend your left leg. Keep the right leg as straight as possible. One more deep breath in. As you exhale, start to walk the hands back, folding down over that left leg, tucking in the chin. Lift that right leg even higher. Feel the intensity of that stretch up the back of your left leg now, breathing through that tension, that tightness. Another inhale, that right leg even higher as you exhale. Take a big step back with that right foot. Rebending into that left knee, sinking the hips down. When you're ready, inhale, reach the arms forward and all the way up. The hips drop a little lower. Keep your left knee over your left ankle. Keep that right leg straight and strong. Another inhale, reach up, stretch it back, exhale, and lower the arms down. Plant both palms, step back to downward facing dog. Take a moment and just breathe. Push the floor away from you as you push the chest back. Slowing the breathing, slowing the heart rate, slowing the fluctuations of the mind. On your inhale, pull yourself forward to the top of a push-up, shifting the shoulders forward over the wrists, making a straight line with the body. If you need a modification, you would simply set the knees down, keep the tail tucked, belly is firm. On your next inhale, look slightly forward. As you exhale, begin to lower, slowly down. With the inhale, curl into cobra. And hold and breathe. Stretch those toes back. Pull your chest forward through those hands. Push heavily into the tops of both feet. Push into those hands. Inhale a little higher. Tuck the toes. Press back to downward dog. Inhale, float to the toes, soft knees, look forward, let your feet come all the way up to your hands. Look forward as you inhale, long spine, fold over the legs as you exhale. Hold here for a moment, let the arms just go, let your toes take just as much weight as your heels. Making sure that your big toes are touching, there's a little space between your knees. Start to bend your knees and let your hips fall back and down. Start to squeeze your knees together, squeeze your thighs together, draw the low belly in. Now inhale, sweep the arms forward and all the way up. Keep the tail tucked, keep the low belly drawn in. Can you look between the hands? If it's too much, look to the top of the wall in front of you or to a point on the ceiling. Point that tailbone down. straighten the legs, reach up, tip back, exhale, reach forward, and fold. Look forward on the inhale, lengthening the spine, take a grip on the ankles or calves, pulling yourself down, and breathe. Draw those shoulders back, away from the ears. Exhale, pull yourself to that furthest place, and then inhale, looking down, releasing the hands down. Take a big step back with the right foot, and walk around to the right of those hands. And now we adjust the feet to about a one leg's length stance. Big toes in, heels turning out. Now look forward as you inhale, bring a bit of weight into your toes, begin to fold down as you exhale, planting the hands as you walk from back, hug the elbows in. Still keeping weight in the toes, using the strength of the arms to pull yourself down and breathe. Last breath in and out. With your next inhale, start to lift the head, transition to palms from forearms. If you came down, begin to heel toe the feet in, little bits at a time. Take it to that more manageable stance and then walk back around to the top of your mat. Come onto the ball of the back foot as you turn your left toes forward. Step back to downward dog. Take a moment. Just breathe.
exhale, lower your knees. Bring them together. Untuck the toes, big toes touch. Sit back on the heels, lower your chest. Lower your forehead. If it doesn't touch the floor, make a pillow with the hands. If your forehead does touch the ground, arms either out in front of you or all the way back alongside you. Place your hands and your thighs and as you inhale, slowly press yourself up into the padottanasana. Take a moment here. Let's bring our hands back to the top of our mat. Tuck the toes. Take it back to a downward facing dog. Step the right foot to the top of the mat. Walk your hands around to the left, pigeon to those feet. Look out in front of you as you inhale, a little bend to the knees as you exhale, hands to the hips. Inhale, come all the way up, see something in front of you. So you want about one of your own legs length in between your two feet as you turn your right toes out. Try to point those right toes straight to the top of your mat, wind your heels up. And then make sure that that right big toe is turned in slightly. Slide the left heel back just a little bit. So you want to turn your left foot in. Arms out to a T. Look down that right arm. Begin to reach out over that right leg. Pause. Draw the left hip back. Draw the left shoulder back. Turn your palms forward. Let that right arm come down. Straight down. Look towards your left hand. Start to lift that left arm all the way up. And breathe here in your triangle. Turn your left palm to face the wall behind you. Can you let your left arm come around behind your back? Maybe hand towards the right buttock, right hip, or inner right thigh. Spiraling open even more. Good. Inhale, left arm to the ceiling. Look down to that right foot as you exhale. Inhale, rise. Palms turn down. Let's bend the right knee, turn the right toes in. Straighten the leg. Pivot and point the left toes out now, lining up heels, sliding the right heel back. Good. Let's start to reach out over that straight leg. So when you reach as far forward as possible, pause, draw that right hip back, draw that right shoulder back, turn your palms forward, let that left arm just come down, straight down. Let that gaze now come back to the right thumb and begin to lift that right arm straight up to the sky. If it's hurting the neck to look at the thumb, know that you can always look out to the side wall or even down to that left big toe. Turn your right palm to face the wall behind you. Let that arm drape across the back, reaching for the left buttock, left hip, or inner thigh. Keep rolling that right shoulder back, pulling both of them down and away from the ears. On your next inhale, right arm reaches up. Look down to the left big toe. Inhale, rise. Palms down. Bending the left knee to turn the left toes in. Straighten the leg. Bring your hands to your hips. Shorten your stance slightly. Turn your right toes out. Turn your left toes out. And bend your knees over your ankles. So adjust your feet as necessary so that your shins are straight up and down. Try not to let your knees go past your ankles. Try not to have those legs unbent, so that your knees are not overtaxed. So adjust your legs. Adjust your feet to point in the same direction as the knees as well. Draw the tailbone down, pull the low belly in. Draw the shoulders back.
Bring your arms to a T, palms open, spread the fingers wide. Sit the hips a little lower, pull the shoulders down, bend the elbows, point your fingers up towards the ceiling. Draw the elbows just slightly back. Sit the hips a little lower. Sit the hips a little lower. Interlacing the fingers, pressing the palms forward, lifting the arms slowly up. Try not to lift the shoulders up, so pause in the lifting of the arms before your shoulders come up towards the ears. See something in front of you, either straight ahead or slightly down, and when you're ready, inhale, lift the heels up, away from the floor. And breathe here. Another deep breath in, and on your exhale, take a little side bend to your right. On an inhale, come back up. And then the lean is to the left. Inhale, come back up. Stand even higher, taller. Pressing up through those palms. Take one more inhale, and as you exhale, lowering the heels, circling the arms down. Bring your hands to your hips. And breathe. Right foot is solid. Lift the left heel, coming onto the ball of the left foot. Swing that knee out to the left like you were opening a gate, but try not to move your hips at all. So your left foot can rest on the floor with the heel above the ankle. You can slide the foot up higher so your toes rest at your ankle. You can slide the foot up so your heel is just below the knee. Or you can pull your foot right up into your inner thigh, but have no side pressure at your knee whatsoever. Keep that knee free and clear of weight. And when you find that place where the foot feels comfortable, bring your hands to your heart. And as you put pressure between your palms, put pressure between your leg and your foot as well, wherever they touch. Coming into parighasana, our tree pose, so the hands can stay here. The palms can stay pressing together and the arms can come straight up to the ceiling. The arms can come straight up and separate hands to shoulder distance or even wider to keep the shoulders down and away from the ears. The ultimate challenge in any balance pose would be either moving your drishti, maybe you're looking upwards, maybe between the palms, maybe you're even working towards the closed eye, a little bit at a time until you find your edge. Down and just observe for a moment. differences between right and left side as the hands come to the hips, that left leg grows solid and rooted. We shift on to the ball of the right foot now. Find your drishti. Start to swing your knee out to the right like you were opening a gate. Hips stay forward. What did you do with your foot on the other side? Try to do the same thing now on this side. Pushing the foot to the leg and the leg to the foot. Bring your palms together, hands to the heart. See your drishti, your gazing point very clearly. And when you're ready, doing the same thing with the arms that you did on the right side. Try not to let your shoulders lift up around your ears at all. Maybe you moved your drishti. Maybe you worked towards a closed eye. Maybe like me, you fell out of the pose when you tried to close the eyes. Don't get frustrated, don't get angry. Just try it again. Breath in. If the eyes are closed, let them open. As you exhale, bring your palms together and your hands to your heart. Let your right knee point forward. Let your right foot settle back down as you relax the arms down. Now we give the left leg a gentle shake. Feet are at a hip distance stance. Hands are on the hips. Tailbone is tucked. Let's inhale, open the heart, open the chest, and look up. As you exhale, take a little back bend here, pushing your hips forward, lifting your heart to the ceiling, really engage your quads now. Inhale, come back up, soften the knees, lead with the heart, and begin to fold. All the way down, reach down for your big toes, take that bind, look forward as you inhale, lean into the toes slightly, start to pull yourself down. The shoulders back and away from the ears. Exhale, release the mind, walk the feet together.
Into
walk your hands up onto your thighs. Maybe you can even walk your hands all the way back behind you, bringing more weight into those feet. Try to let your hips really melt towards those heels. Feel that stretch through the soles of the feet. Feel that stretch in your toes.
Lower your back, lower your
flexing both the feet. Take a deep breath in. Start to lower your legs to the right, but hover them as you turn your head to the left, keeping your left shoulder just where it was. Squeeze your knees together, squeeze your ankles together. On an inhalation, the head and the knees come up, and then change sides as you exhale, hovering the legs, don't lift the right shoulder. On your next inhale, come up, and now we move knees right, head and left. Inhale, center. And then use the exhale to make the legs to the left and turn the head to the right. Inhale, center. Legs to the right, head to the left. Inhaling to come up. And switch as you exhale. Try to keep those knees together. This time as you take your legs over to the right, hover them once again. Take another deep breath in here in this position, and as you exhale, set your feet down. Turn your palms up. Draw the shoulders down away from the ears. And just relax and breathe. Take another long, slow, deep breath in. Exhaling to let all that air go as you press your palms down, re-engage the legs. Inhale, come back up. Exhaling, take the legs to the left and hover them as you look to the right. Holding, breathing. Take another full breath in, and as you exhale, set the feet down, turn the palms up, and breathe. Upper back melting. Facial muscles softening. Breath deepening as much as possible. Challenge your lungs every time you inhale to take 1/10 more air in. Challenge your lungs as you exhale to push 1/10 more air out. Thank you. those arms 1 inch, squeezing the hands, the fists, wrists, forearms, elbows, upper arms, shoulders, squeeze and drop the arms down. Let your head turn slowly to the right. And then take it all the way to center and all the way to the left. Let your head roll to center one more time to the right. And one more time all the way to the left. Nice and slow. Come back through center. Lift the head just an inch. Tuck the chin and gently set the head down. Take every muscle of your face and squeeze everything towards the tip of your nose. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Open the mouth, open the eyes. Let the mouth close. Let the eyes close. Let the tip of the tongue rest there, just behind the top front teeth, just at the roof of the mouth. Let the rest of the tongue fall away from the roof of the mouth and sink down towards your throat. Let your whole body be still, so if there's any last final adjustments that you need to make for your personal comfort, make them. So happy to have you here joining us for yoga. Thank you for continuing to share this with your friends. If you have any special requests, please let us know. We would happily add any poses you would like to see into your practice. And hopefully we'll see each other really soon. Maybe we can set up